They say that love is only for the lucky and the strong. Well, right now I feel neither. You know, fellow artists ask me, actors, singers, performers, they say, Paul, don't you get tired of fighting, Paul? Don't you get tired of fighting? You're so relentless, Paul. You're so relentless. You never quit. You never give up. Don't you get tired? I tell them that it is the goal of the artist to try to save the soul of humanity. An artist must fight for freedom or slavery. I made my choice. I had no alternative. I gotta stop this drinking. I don't trust their medicine. My doctor tells me he thinks I'm bipolar. I said, doctor, what do you mean you think? And what is bipolar? Then he's got to take 10 minutes to go find a book to open it to try to find so he can read it to me. I said, come on, doctor, I can't be the smartest person in this room. You know, there's a reason it's so quiet in here. No radio or sound. My name is all over the news, everywhere you turn. My name's all over. Everybody's talking about me. Everywhere, newspaper, radio, TV, everywhere. They're scandalizing my name. Apparently, this old artist, colored artist, Negro, in Harlem is responsible for what rich white dictators do all the way in Russia. They're telling me that my good friend Joseph Stalin, the Russian premier, that he's become a monster, that he's guilty of mass genocide, of killing thousands and hundreds of thousands of his countrymen and the Jewish people. I don't know what to believe. They've got a state-run media, and we've got a bunch of liars. I don't know what to believe. I mean, the Joseph Stalin that I know was a kind, considerate man who treated me with dignity and grace. And not one time did my color of my skin ever come into matter. He treated me well, he paid me handsomely, and he treated Slan and I as equals. So I don't know what to believe. But if it's true, I'm devastated. As you all know, I've always been an advocate for peace and a good friend to the Jewish people. But now my enemies are using it against me. They're saying it's Paul Robeson's fault. He was used, he touted their cause. He set up a superior lifestyle, a utopian lifestyle, socialism, communism. He touted their cause, he was used. Shame on Paul Robeson, shame on Paul Robeson, shame on Paul Robeson, shame on me. No, America. No, shame on you. Shame on you. You don't get to take the moral high ground. Shame on you. Shame on all of you. Shame on you. Shame on me. You know, slavery and the Holocaust wasn't caused by whips and chains and gas and guns. No. It was human arrogance. Human arrogance. Human arrogance. Men aspiring to the wisdom of God. Human arrogance. America, England, France, your Western arrogance allowing you to treat us Africans as though we're children of some lesser God. Shame on me. Shame on you. Shame on all of you. Shame on all of you. No nation comes to the table with clean hands. No nation comes to the table with clean hands. You've all got blood on your hands. You've all got blood on your hands. America, England, France, Germany, Russia, China, you've all got blood on your hands. Only in your case, America, in your case, the blood on your hands. Is mine. You know, I wish I didn't know some of the things that I know. I wish I hadn't seen some of the things I've seen. I wish I hadn't heard some of the things I've heard. I wish I hadn't gone some of the places and countries I've gone. Because I know what you pretend not to know. That is, mankind isn't kind. Not to men who look like me. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how many awards I win, how many degrees I have, how intelligent I am, how much success I have, how much money I have. You're always going to see me as three-fifths of a man. Three-fifths of a man. Always. Because my sin is my skin. My skin is my sin. You know, I'm not a perfect man. You know, I've made some mistakes. I'm not a perfect man, but I try. I try. My father used to tell us and read to us, say in the Bible, which says that, it says that there's a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. It says there's a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole. Do you think maybe there's enough balm for me? You know, sometimes when I get too depressed like this and Eslanda can't take it anymore, she calls our good friend Langston Hughes. And Langston would come over and he would sit with me in the dark. And he would say, Paul, it's not that the Negro people don't love you, Paul. They just don't have the intellect to understand you. He says that you're a valedictorian with a law degree. They're lucky if they got a year of high school. Paul, you've traveled the world 10 times over. You speak 10, 15 languages. They are struggling to learn one. He said, Paul, it's not that the Negro people don't love you. They just don't have the intellect to understand you. You're too smart for the room, Paul. I know it's a lonely, lonely place to be. A stranger in your own country, amongst your own people. But you're too smart for the room, Paul. You're too smart for the room. You know, I can't think too much. Doctors are right about one thing. If I think too much, I get depressed. And I gotta put on some music, or read a book, or some poetry or something. Or something, some poetry. some poetry. Oh my God, what was that? What was that poem that Langston Hughes? Langston Hughes, he wrote a new poem. Oh my God, Langston Hughes is not calling himself colored anymore. Not Negro either. Oh my God, he's so progressive. He's calling himself black now. Just black. Yeah, Langston Hughes, he's calling himself black now. He wrote a poem about it. Oh God, it's so beautiful. How did it go again? How did it go? Oh yeah. To fling my arms wide in the face of the sun, to dance and to whirl till the white day is done. Then rest at pale evening under a tall, slim tree. Night coming tenderly, black like me.